So yesterday we were hearing about the Hira Panchami. Hira means searching, to search. Hira means to search, Dhurna. Panchami means the fifth day of Rath Yatra. Panchami means Panchami. That's why Bhagavad Gita said, Rathyadastra Dutiya. Okay, on the, it's not the actually Panchami Tithi, it is Panchami means after the fifth day of yes Rathyatra, that is or sixth day, so that is why it is Panchami. So externally we have heard about the Rath Yatra Katha, but actually Jagannath Ji, how he was relishing the Ras Madhurya. Rasik Sekhar Krishna Paramakarno, being a Rasik Krishna and he is so much merciful, so how he was relishing the Ras Madhurya. So the same Katha Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told to our relishing with the Swarup Damodar and all the devotees. Yes, yesterday I told you, as our Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami was describing, that how Mahaprabhu is describing that play. He didn't play actually. Mahaprabhu is just like an audience. He is just like a visitor. And he was just watching that drama, watching that play. What was that play? Anybody remember? That Lakshmi Devi, how she dressed up royal, royal dressed, and how she was staying in the palanquin and chewing the betel nuts, and both of their side there are many maid servants performing dance and singing. So many people are playing the many instruments, and then they are going to search their husbands, his husband. Because Lakshmi Devi got maan that time. So we have heard this thing. So Mahaprabhu, seeing that, so what he did? So he covered his face and he was laughing. So Mahaprabhu said, this is not the symptoms of maan. So Mahaprabhu himself told to Swarup Damodar, hey Swarup Damodar,
मुनि न बसन
So at that time, Mahaprabhu, so he asked the question to Swarupdhamavada, what is actually Maan? So here we are sitting, or here we are sitting to play, to see the, or to watching the play. So what is actually drama? What is actually Maan? So he was asking to Swarupdhamavada, so Lakshmi Devi is really got Maan? So now we are entering little bit Siddhant, that what is Maan actually, otherwise we will not be able to understand it. Just like according to the scriptures, how many kinds of Nayak? 96 kinds of types of Nayak and 360 types of Nayika, heroine. So little bit mathematical calculation we are doing here, otherwise we won't be able to enter into that principle. There are 96 kinds of Nayak, heroes. Nayak is first Purna, Purnatar, Purnatam, who is Dwarka, Mathura and Vrindavan. Dwarka is called Purna, means complete. Mathura is called more complete, and Mathura and Vrindavan is called most complete. So it becomes three. And then further we are calculating it in a general way. There are three kinds of Nayak. Six. पति उपपति 24 कैलकुलेशन इज वेरी हार्ड सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड योर सेल्फ सो अकॉर्डिंग टू जस्ट आई टेल यू अकॉर्डिंग टू द मैथमेटिक्स मे बी यू कैन रिमेंबर दैट And there are three kinds of Nayika, heroines, 360 kinds of Nayikas. Nayika. There is also calculation very nicely. First Nayika we take, one is Swakya Parkya, who is married and unmarried. Parkya means who got married and after that she have a little external affair. She is called Parkya. But in this world, Parkya is very hatred, very criticized. So it becomes two. Mugdha, Sulabdha, Pragalva. Mugdha, Magdha, Pragalva. Mugdha, Magdha, Pragalda. Mukta is one type. Madha is three type. And Pragalva is three type. Seven multiply. Six, seven. Ek prakar ka. One type of Mugdha. स्वकीय पर किया इट बिकम्स 7 मल्टीप्लाई टू 14 वन इज कॉल कर्णिका हु डिडंट गॉट मैरिड एंड दे आर वेरी स्मॉल वेरी यंग बिकम्स 15
फिर कहते हैं क्या देखो फर्स्ट प्रकार के नायिका
जरा इस काइंड्स ऑफ नायिकास अभिसारिका उत्कंठिता सो देर आर एट काइंड्स ऑफ नायिकास सो 15 मल्टीप्लाई 8 इट बिकम्स 3 यस 120
कितना हो गया
एन 120 मल्टीप्लाई 3
फिर कितना रह गया फिर
3
उत्तम
मध्यम एंड कनिष्ठ नायिकास सो नाउ इट बिकम्स 360 60 सो देयर आर 360 काइंड्स ऑफ नायिका रोल वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की जय जयकार
और 96 प्रकार के क्योंकि ये हमारे विशेष कोई सिचुएशन है पर हम पिछले कर
सो नाउ व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग इट बिकॉज़ महाप्रभु he would like to hear this subject that what is actually man he would like to hear this because there are four kinds of separation purvarag man pravas or premo vaichitra what is man actually here now we are discussing about man what is called man actually little we have to understand we are not going to deeper What is man? When isne becomes very condensed form, so that is called isne become pranay. Isne turns into pranay. And in other scriptures, in any shastra, it goes to man. So when your love is too becomes too much condensed, that is called isne. And isne, what is the meaning of isne? When the heart is melted, when your heart is melted, that is called isne. So he hearing some kathas or remembering the past times when hearts becomes melted that is called isneha in general ways what are the symptoms of isneha so how your heart will be melted your the tears will rolling down comes out from your eyes but in the vatsalya ras sometimes milk comes out from the breast when that man isnehi becomes so much condensed just like when we boil the milk so while we are boiling it so it became so milk becomes so much condensed and the taste of that milk becomes so much sweeter in the same way when the isnehi becomes so much condensed love becomes prem becomes sneh and sneh turned into the man in some scriptures it goes to pranay and some scriptures are saying it goes to directly man so some acharya path told sneh after sneh they sneh turned into the man and some scriptures also told that sneh turns into the pranay and then pranay after that man what is actually pranay pranay means where the heart and mind it's become connected there is nothing no difference that time is pranay so there is no kinds of feelings like it's your and mine oneness when the oneness comes that is called pranay na tam your heart and my heart there is no difference that is called pranay when oneness comes that is called pranay that's why in the marriage card it is written pranay milan meeting of pranay
pranay means sutra mein
parini gane sanskar parini gane so that kinds of tiredness is called is pranay bandhan I didn't get married but I got married so many peoples I arranged the marriage of so many peoples maybe thousands of peoples So I never break anybody's marriage. I always speak the person, if you are in the marital life, so stay happy. Sarve santu niramaya. I never suffer anybody. So according to the maya, according to their own karma, they are detached from each other. So whatever the work is maya, so they are doing. Until they are living together, they should live. We always bless. Sarve bhavantu sukhina. Always, everybody live happy. Sarve santu niramaya. Sarve bhadrani pashyantu. Everybody performs the bhajan. Wherever you are, if we are staying in the, so if you are stay at home, and if you are staying at the out of the house, so always perform bhajan. If you are grass or tyagi, you should perform bhajan. Is it possible that somebody can perform bhajan being tyagi? No. Vichar. So there are many gun of Mahaprabhu, all are grast. Amongst them, most of the grast. That's why being grast is somebody is inferior and he is not performing well. It is not. So that's why the person who is performing bhajan of Krishna, he is the greater. Many person they are performing bhajan in grastha. So their husband, wife and their children, they are performing bhajan. So maybe sometimes we got ego, oh I am the sannyasi, I am the tyagi, so I am performing bhajan. And all the grastha they are not performing bhajan. Oh no, it's not like that. Please never think like that. That's why Narottam Das is saying, Narashi is also saying, Narashi is praising Yudhishthira Maharaj so much. This is not ordinary thing. That's why sometimes we got this kind of feeling in our heart that he is gross, he is not performing bhajan, and I am the sannyasi and tyagi, so I am performing the bhajan. No, somebody gets this kind of ego, so it's not right. So that's why we never break somebody's marriage. Okay, if you are got married, then always perform bhajan. Sarve santu nirvaya, sarve bhadrani pashyantu ma kaschit dukbhagoet. Nityanand Prabhu got two married. And after he gave up the sannyas ashram, then he got married. I always connected the people. Every time I used to say, never leave bhajan, jodo, connect the people. Never leave your wife, always connect with your wife. Jodo, connect the people and perform the bhajan. So the katha we were hearing about, discussing about. So Mahaprabhu was watching this leela, that how Lakshmi Devi was sitting in a very nice palanquin and she was going to search her husband. So she is a very chaste lady. And Lakshmi ji so much angry that time. And being so much angry, manka lakshan. So she was chewing the betel nuts. So much, so many kinds of maid servants are fanning chamar, and she was sitting in the palanquin, and the maid servants are dancing and playing so much instrument there. So this is angriness. So seeing that Mahaprabhu, he was laughing. This is Leela was going on. This was the playing was, the drama was going on. So I given the example yesterday, because whenever we were in village, so that the play started from 8 p.m. and midnight, so long it was going on. But nowadays what happens, the play started very soon and end up in a 1.5 hour only, 1 or 2 hours. So they would like to ekagra the mind, the stable the mind of the people. So as I, that's why I told you yesterday about some katha. I told you the singer came and he was saying because the stadium was full of the people. They gave in 1,000 rupees. People who are not aware about the Shastriya Sangeet, the classical music, who are not aware about the classical music, so they were saying, so how many people will come? All have come. So all the ticket were distributed and the full of stadium was full of the audience, and now he is singing like so. So what is this? How many people has to come? Everybody has to come. It is house full now. Because the person who have knowledge, so they are taking, they are enjoying that that music, the classical music. So the person who care about that, so they were not taking enjoy there. So they were saying many people have come, so why he is saying like this? So there are many kinds of Ujjal Neelmani. There are many kinds of Naikas described there. What is Naika and Nayak? So Gurudev has established these kinds of, Gurudev has described this very nice Granth. We should read that Granth. Gurudev spent so much time there. So Granth always used to study. Sometimes it is not like that you have taken the Granth and you are putting in the almirah. It's not like that. You should always study. It is full of dust. No. Every time you have to, whenever you buy the Granth, you should read that. You should study. Because Gurudev did so much hard work, so it is shouldn't we go waste. So that's why always giving the enthusiasm to the people. Wherever I go in the foreign countries, I used to say to the people, because Gurudev did so much hard work and he has written so many granthas, so everybody has to read that, study that granthas. He has given so much time. So that's why everybody has granth in his house and they have to study that. So then the hard work of our Gurudev will be successful. So this is called Vraha Mridanga Seva. What is Guru Seva actually? This is Vraha Mridanga Seva. If you are studying the Granth of the Gurudev, that is nice Seva. So the talking we were describing about Man, we have a little bit discussed. When Isne becomes condensed, so what is Man? Seeing your beloved, you get so much kinds of envy and many kinds of feelings comes, adverse feeling comes in your mind, that is called Man. Just like the snakes goes in a zigzag way, so in the same way Man is like zigzag way. Sometimes there is a quarreling between husband and wife. Actually, it is not Man. This is a different thing. So after so many times when husband is speaking, so wife is replying one time. So actually, this is not Man. This is Ahankar. This is Guman. And if she will do like this many times, then wife, then husband will beat the wife. So all kinds of Man will go away of the wife. So there is a one kinds of vegetable which is called Man Sabji. Just like Arvi. Man Kachu. There is a process. So if somebody knows the process of how to make that sabji, so it will not catch your throat. This boy is know very nicely. He's a cook. Why? How that maan grows, that vegetable grows, they have to give so much chai bhasma there, in the roots, then it grows. Maan kachu, that vegetable name is maan kachu. So there is a process to make that. So if you know the process to make that, so it will not catch your throat. If somebody doesn't know how to make it, the process to how to make it, so that vegetable will cut your throat. There will so much pain in your heart. I have eaten this many times. So the people who know about who know how to make it, what is the process to make it, so always give that opportunity to them to make that vegetable. So when you eat that vegetable, so you will get so much taste in that. So there is a process to make. There is a process thing how to make it. It will not catch your throat anyway, a little bit. And if somebody got maan, so it will catch the throat. So Mahaprabhu, seeing that, he was laughing. So at the time, Sarudamodar saying, Prabhu, I have never seen such a maan. This is not maan. I just bringing you a little bit more Siddhant. Whenever I read so much Siddhant, so my head is fanning. I am fainting. Because at the time of that, nobody reminds the shloka. There, if somebody is pronounced two akshar, two letters, someone reminds three letters, which our Param Gurudev, he never recites so many shlokas. Bhakti Pragyan Srila Kesava Goswami Maharaj, he always just reminds, starting with a little bit shloka, and he comes to the purport. So I have heard his lecture. There is a Param Guru Maharaj, whenever you heard the lecture of Param Guru Maharaj, he never recites full shloka. He just recites only half shloka and goes to the purport. Govinda Bhujakrit, like the Dwarika is saved and covered by the blessings of Krishna. So he was just reciting that shloka very little way in a starting. The person who are reciting so many shlokas, so people used to say, oh, he is very scholar. Actually, it's not like that. Many people are speaking shloka, but they don't know what is the actual meaning. So amongst them, some Vidwan, the scholars are sitting, maybe just like you all are very scholar, you also are intelligent in speaking shlokas and you know the meaning also. So Mahaprabhu, he was laughing. So Sarudamodar is saying, Prabhu, I have never seen such a man. That's why our Acharya Pad used to say, one is anger and one is manavas, and the third one is man. One is krodh, which is anger, and second is maan abhas, look like maan. Maan abhas and maan, the three are not same. When krodh happens, when your desires is not fulfilled, when there is a little bit disturbance or obstacle comes in fulfilling your desires, so that time we get krodh. Bhagwan is saying in the same way. When the krodh come, when there is a little obstacles comes in your sense gratifications. If just take an example of little child, if he is asking for something, so what happens? So she is catching that thing. So but that child got so much growth, he started beating his mother, and mother knows that this is not beneficial for that child. So mother used to say, she always catching the thing before that child. Just like just like a child is going to catch the fire, so mother is removing his hand, but that child is always crying, oh, why are you obstacle me, there is obstacles come. So in the same way, because he is not aware about that, so what happened? So when mother little bit carried the hand of his child little bit towards the fire, so he was, oh ma, oh yes, like this. So he was so much fearing. So in actually Lakshmi Devi don't get such a maan, it is just like krodh, maan or manavas. It is not maan and manavas, it is krodh. Manavas, where manavas comes? In the Dwarkapuri. Satyabhama and other Mahishniya, they got manavas. I used to told a story once day. Krishna performing the Grastha Leela, and he destroyed the man of Satyabhama. Once Narishi came, so he carried the Parijat Pushpa in that assembly, and he said, Prabhu, give me the benediction that who is the topmost deer queen to you, so you can give that Parijat Pushpa to that lady, that queen. So Krishna gave the Parijat Pushpa to Rukmani. Satyabhama got so much man. Actually that was not man, that was jealousy. It was just kind of jealousy, that is. Anyhow, Krishna rectified her man. He went to Swarga, he defeated Indra and got that Parijat trees, and he assembled that Parijat trees into the court of Satyabhama. And then there was a festival was celebrating there. They did the bhandara there. In the Roop Sanatan, there are many kinds of bhandara used to happen every day. So actually it is saying it is not the man of Satyabhama, it is just like a manabhas. When somebody do maan, so they used to do kop bhavan, and they wear very kinds of maan vastra. So whatever I have done the maan, so my priyatam will come to me and please me. So in this way, Swarup Damodar is saying, what is actually maan? Somebody is getting so much malin vastra, and they will, drag the soil from the in the land. You know, thinking of what is it? So it is mentioned in the Bhagavatam, Sanatan Goswami Pad is describing. I used to tell sometimes when Krishna's Leela, which one? Nava Vrindavan Leela. So early morning Krishna got up and he went to Vrindavan. He was thinking, dreaming that, oh, everything is like a Vrindavan. So he was taking the darshan of all that things, and all the Mahishyas are taking the darshan that Krishna is staying in the Dwarika. That how Krishna is relishing the love between Braj. And Krishna is thinking that I am in Vrindavan, because he was getting the stimulation of all kinds of pastime in Vrindavan. And he saw Ma Yashoda is churning the milk butter, and there was a fresh butter she is giving to Krishna. it was a statue. Krishna is thinking everything is true, everything is real. Then further he moved, he saw that gopis are standing some way on the way, and when Krishna moved forward, so he saw that Radhaji is standing. Radhaji is standing. That all things was artificial, a statue. But Krishna is thinking this is all true, all is real. So when he went too close to Radha's chin hand, he put his flute to the chin of Radhaji, and Krishna, and he embraced and kissed her, and Krishna is feeling all is real. Padma. So the Kansa father Ugrasen wife Padma, she was so much lusty that time, seeing that she was trying to catch Krishna. Oh, he is Krishna himself. At the time, all the people stopped at Padmavati. So seeing that Satyabhama, what man. How Krishna is loving more than us to Radha and other gopis. So at that time, Satyabhama returned back and she went to Kopabhavan. And Krishna moved forward. He saw there is a beautiful place. There is a ocean, blue water. So he saw, oh, there is no. He was thinking that it is Yamuna, but he was saying there is a waves. So much waves are coming, and he came to know it's not Vrindavan. It is Dwarkapuri. It is ocean here. Then Krishna turned back. When he returned back to the Sudharma Sabha, all the people, he was surrounded Krishna, and Krishna saw one person is Satyabhama. Satyabhama was not presented in that assembly. So Krishna asked to Uddhav, "Hey Uddhav, where is the daughter of Satrajit, Satyabhama? Where is she?" At that time Uddhav said, "Hey Prabhu, because you presented the Vrindavan Leela, you have presented the Bhava of Vrindavan, so that's why she got Maan. So that's why she is in the Maan Bhavan, Maan Kopa Bhavan." So in that time, the Krishna in that course, what he said, "Oh, that the daughter of Satrajit." He didn't say Satyabhama. He didn't say the daughter of Satrajit. And this time, she won't be present in this assembly. Then I will give up her all the time, for all the time. Call her. So Krishna was saying this word very seriously. So at that time he went to with Satyabhama to taking Parijat Pushpar, but now Krishna is very serious. So Uddhav knocked the door of Satyabhama and called to Satyabhama, "Hey Satyabhama, give up your man one, otherwise Krishna is very serious this time. Put on some beautiful dress and ornaments and come into the assembly, otherwise Krishna will give up you. He will never accept you. He will sacrifice you." So now Krishna is very serious. So when Satyabhama heard that, so Satyabhama was, her body was trembling. She gave up all kinds of man and everything. So what she did, she dressed up very nicely and put on the ornaments, and she presented herself into the assembly and sitting very, very behind. At that time, Krishna was so much serious. He was so grave. He was saying these words like, "Whatever kinds of love and affection I show you, I am not a lusty person. I am not the puppet of you. So you cannot understand the discrimination between your love and the Vrijvasi love. Your love is..." I don't know what is that. Something for balancing, there is a used word Pashan. So you are not like them, you are just like a Pashan. So the Braj Gopi's love, you doesn't have like that prem, you don't know anything. And I am not a lusty person. A lusty person, so he is always controlled by the ladies, but I am not like that. So whatever I got married with all of you, So when I saw the Roop Madhurya of you, so for just remembering the pastime of that. But the Braj Gopis have the feelings of that, the Madhurita of the love of Braj Gopis, it's always attracted to me. You cannot attract me by that. So Krishna has described in the shloka, so Krishna was not controlled by the love and Madhurya of that Mahishiniyas. So Krishna is saying in this way, I am staying in this Dwarika, why? Just because of your love? No. I always day and night remember the gopis. If gopis give me permission, then at once I can give up all of you. I can reach myself to Vrindavan. So Krishna giving so much beautiful lecture there, very seriously, that all the Mahishinyas, they were stunned. So this is called actually, so Mahishinya Satyabhama, that was not man. It is just like manabhas. And man, what is man? When Priyatama, beloved, for his lover, and she ruling upon them, so why that ruling, they understand that leaving me, he cannot go anywhere. Nirantaram vashikrata pratiti nandanandane vashi kada karishyasi mai kripa katakshi bhajana. Radha and other gopis have this kinds of firm faith, and they have realization that Krishna cannot leave us. He cannot go leave us and to go anywhere. Just like I used to give an example, once Krishna, he was relishing love with gopis. So Krishna told to gopi, every day you used to abuse me. You are thief, you are lumpat. So you used to give me this kinds of. So from tomorrow onwards, I won't come to you. So gopis are saying, oh, who have seen that tomorrow? You can leave the kunj tomorrow. You can go straight away. You can go away from here. Because gopis know that Krishna cannot go anywhere to leave us. So because they have this kinds of firm faith. So when this firm faith has so much condensed, and Krishna is tied with that love, that's why it is saying that Krishna never go to leave Vrindavan anywhere. Vrindavanam pratijam padigam na gachami. So the love of Vrindavan, so why that love, Krishna is completely tied. Just like performing Leela and increasing your love, so it is showing that Krishna went from Vrindavan to Mathura, Mathura to Dwarika, but actually Vrindavan, Krishna, Shyam Sundar, Vrijendandan Shyam Sundar, he never went out from Vrindavan. Because Krishna himself saying, Vrindavan pratijam padengam na gachami. So who went out? So all his incarnation, all his prakash, the expansion gone from Vrindavan. This is very nicely described. Maybe you have heard. So Krishna is tied with himself, with the Vraj love. And he is tied with the love of Radhaji. That's why Krishna's leelas are so much sweet. That's why our Jaya Goswami Pad written, Smaral Garal Khandanam Mama Shirshi Mandam Deha Pad Pallavam Udhar. Krishna was not doing this activity being a lusty person. Externally we are saying Krishna is behaving like a lusty person. Actually no, this is the transcendental love. That's why Krishna is called Priyasi Vashibhuta. This is the speciality. It is no Nayak have this kinds of quality. That's why Krishna is saying Dhir Lalit Nayak. So this is the quality of Dhir Lalit Nayak. There are four kinds of quality. Just like our Prabhupada Saraswati Pad in the Radha Rasa Dynasty, he has described it in a beautiful shloka. Yatkincham Kakuvara. It is written in the Rupa Sanatan also. If somebody wants to read, he can read. So Krishna is controlled by the Priyasi, by the gopis. So just because of that love, Krishna is twisting his ear. The gopis are twisting the ears of Krishna. So which is not possible to Brahma and other devsa, but gopis are doing the same things. So he has put his mor mukut, peacock crown, on the feet of Radha ji. Hey Radhe, I have sailed my hat into your feet. But still Radha ji is not giving the mercy. Then Krishna, at least what he said, hey Tehi Tava Pallav Kam Udaram, hey Srimati Radhike, you have so much beautiful feet, please keep that on my head. Ramchand can say this? No. No Nayak in the Rashas can do this. But Krishna, he did all these things. So who are drawing it themselves in the Rashas, only they can understand that where is the love is actually. What is the definition of love? And gopis are doing many kinds of love. I am just telling you one story. Once, what happened? Radha ji was making a garland of flowers, and that garland, this is our Goswami Katha. When she was making the garland, so she said to one sakhi to please go and give this to Krishna. So at that time, Krishna was cowherding with his friends. So what that sakhi, she showed that garlands. So she showed that garlands to Krishna and put into the tree. So Krishna saw this. So then all his friends, what happened at the time, the crow, so thinking that it's his food, because that garland was tied in the tree, so the crow thinking there is a food, so he started carrying that. So kunj, so Chandravali was sitting with her friend, so that crow thrown that garlands to Chandravali's place. So what happened? Chandravali friends Padmavati, she opened that mala. Oh, who made this garland? The person who is making the garland for Thakurji can understand who has made this garland. Because every sakhi has their feelings. Many people are sitting here. If everybody make the garland, so that mala will, everybody's mala, everybody's garland will be different, because they have different feelings. So Chandravali's friends are thinking, who had made this beautiful garland? Maybe this is the prashadi mala of Govind. What Chandravali did? She put that mala on his hair. So when she put that garlands on his hair, so Padmavati, the friends of Chandravali, she put that mala into the hair of Chandravali. So she was so much, she got so much man that I have got the garland of Krishna. So Chandravali, she wearing that garland and she went to where all the Radhajis and Sakhis are staying. So Radhaji saw that garland on the hair of Chandravali. So Radhaji was thinking, oh, how Krishna is so much fool that he has given my garland to that Chandravali. And then Radhaji got man that time. So 2-3 days Radha ji, she didn't meet with Krishna. And Krishna was so much astonished. What happened? I told you, duty, what is the message, what is the work of duty? Praising. Prashansa karna. I told you yesterday about this. What is the, there are 5 points of subject was there. I told you yesterday. If you have to be gopi, so you have to learn 5 subjects. You have to study that very nicely. Maybe you are brahmachari, vanprasth, ganasa, sannyasi, whatever you are, you have to study that 5 shastra. 5. Everybody has to read 5 shastra. It's not my shlok. Rup Goswami Pad. This shlok is written by Rup Goswami Pad. Bhakti Rasama Sindhu. Okay, pata nahi phir. Mool granth is So in the Bhakti Rasama Sindhu he has quoted, but the mool granth, the origin granth is Rup Goswami Pad. I told yesterday 5 subject about. So the context on a time for Aarti. So Radha ji got maan. Why she got this man? Because Krishna was so much, not was happy, pleasing. But when later Krishna met with Radha ji, because he did so much praising to Radha Rani, because some sakis are doing the work of praising. When Nayak and Nayika got man, so they used to prashansa kare, they used to do istav and stuti to each other. They used to tell them. So in this way, Radha ji, the Krishna Pakshi Sakhi, there are 4 kinds of Sakhis, so Paksha, Vipaksha, Tatastha and Swadha Paksha. And then Krishna Pakshi Sakhi, Radha Pakshi Sakhi, one is Nyut Sama Sakhi, Ubhanisht, who has Saman Bhav, 3 times of Sakhis there. You have to study all these things, otherwise really hard to translate. There are many kinds of sakhis. So that sakhi, the Krishna Pakshi sakhi, Chandra, Vrinda, Vrinda, Vrindarika, Ganishta, these all are the Krishna Pakshi sakhi, who have so much affection towards Krishna, who is near towards Krishna. According to the Sne, Krishna is Nadi, Radha Snadi Sakhi. Obhay Nish, Obhay Snadi means they are neutral. Obhay Snadi are Ashta Sakhiya, Lalita Vishaka. These all are Obhay Nishta. And all the Manjiris are Radha. Manjiris. These all are the Manjiris are Radha Nishta. Sakhi, Nitha Sakhi, Pran Sakhi, Pne Sakhi, Pran Peshta Sakhi. So leave 1 and 2. 2 and 3 numbers, they are manjaris, Nitya Sakhi and Prana Sakhi. They all are manjaris and they are Radha Pakshiya. If you will not understand this, then you can understand the man vagera. Mahaprabhu, why Mahaprabhu is laughing, you cannot understand that. So that's why you have to written all these things, read all these things. Are Baba, time. So now Radha ji's man is little bit decreased, and then she met with Krishna. So we will, this is called man. What is man actually? For giving the pleasure to his priyajan, the near and dear. If your priyajan is not getting pleasure, so they feel so much pain in their hearts. This is described very nicely. That's why Radha ji, she got Radha ji's and Gopi's maan, because just like the stream of Ganga is divided into many streams, in this same way Gopi's maan is in different ways. Aur Premanande Hari Hari Bol. Now the time for aarti. Hare Krishna. Radhe. Hari Bol. Nobody clapped.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare.